With a career stretching across three decades, today's guest was a boyzone boy band star in the 90s and had a huge solo career in the noughties. He's back with his ninth studio album. We welcome the one and only Ronan Keating.
How are you doing?
Hello, how are you?
Very good, thanks. Really
great. Good, that's what I like to hear.
Yes.
It's lovely to see you. Looking very well.
I'm surviving.
You're surviving.
Still out of
Still out of all those years on.
All those years later, yes.
So let's talk about the latest album. Mm-hmm. The first single you released from that album was called Fires.
Yeah.
It was like a big sing-along song. Really cool. I loved it.
Yeah, it was a big pop record. It kind of harked back to my first solo album, like Life is a Roller Coaster, Loving Each Day. It's just a big anthemic pop tune. And I really enjoyed making this record. It's nice to be back with some new material after 6 years. Yeah,
this is the thing, you've taken a bit of time out, so it's nice for you to get back in studio.
Yeah, but writing again and recording again properly. I did the Burt Bacharach record and the, you know, the Songs from My Mother, but they weren't, you know, new studio records, so it's nice just to be back with something fresh and new and back on the radio.
Exactly. Where we like you to be. Back on the radio.
So,
and TV
you.
Of course.
Yes, of course. Yes.
So Wasted Light is a follow-up single. It's got a bit of a country vibe to it, I'd say. Really uplifting. So what can you tell us about it?
Wasted Light is it is a kind of a folky kind of feel to it, I guess, in a way. I guess it's a song about, you know, moving on in your life, about, you know, saying goodbye to the past, which is kind of interesting. But it's that kind of thing really. And but it's got an optimistic, you know, vibe about it, about, you know, the future, really.
Yeah, definitely. Now, when it comes to music videos, you filmed a lot in your time. So do you find them a bit like, oh, another music video? Or do you still get quite excited about filming them?
I try and get excited about it. I try and think of something new every time, you know, especially now, trying to find an original idea is really hard. And I think they're the best videos, when you find something that's clever. It doesn't need to be necessarily expensive to make it or whatever, but when you put a little bit of thought into it, and it's a little different. This video, Wasted Light, the newest one, funny enough, it's more of an animation. I just did a performance on it on a kind of a green screen.
Handy.
Yeah, very easy. Shot it in Sydney. And then I have this brilliant animator here in London, actually, who drew all of that stuff. And it was nice. It told its story and it, you know, through the pictures.
Yeah, it does the job.
Yeah.
Don't really need to be there, do you?
I didn't actually need to be in it. When we were making the video, I kept saying, take me out, I'm in it too much. So there's a whole like 15 seconds at the beginning that I'm not in it at all. Originally I was in it. I didn't need to be in it.
Exactly. You know,
I'm sick of looking at my mush. Not enough.
Yeah. I don't know if your fans want to hear that.
Yeah, of course they do.
Now, unexpectedly, the new album only has about two ballad songs and the rest of it's really uplifting pop music. So why did you decide to keep it uplifting and only have a few ballads?
I guess I've done so many ballads and I wanted this album to be optimistic, to be about kind of hopeful for people. And that's why I kind of kept going down the up-tempo route. Everything we were writing, I was like, no, I'm not doing that. No, stop playing the piano. No, no, stop it. Stop, you know, stop strumming those sad chords. Come on, let's do it. Dance tracks. Gang, gang, gang. Yeah, let's do it.
Let's get raving in the studio.
Yeah, man, proper. I even have a rapper on this one of the tracks, Lullaby, which was quite interesting. Kiz, who's really great. So, I mean, it's just different. I think you need to think outside the box
now. Exactly.
I got to think of something different and fresh.
With so many albums, you have got to keep it quite fresh, haven't
beard,
you?
Beard, yeah, old man, walking stick, you know, it's frightening.
As you mentioned earlier, so this is your it's been 6 years since your last studio album. So did you just take a nice, well-earned break?
No, I haven't stopped. I have had albums in the interim, you know, in the middle that were kind of, you know, concept albums with orchestras and stuff like that. And they were cover albums. But 6 years since I made a studio record with new material. So, no, I've been busy at it. And I was down in Australia doing X Factor down there and all sorts of different things. So, no, I've been very busy.
Been doing loads of stuff. Mm. Yeah, cool. Yeah. So let's talk about the tour you're going to be going on.
Yeah.
2013, you're going to do...
Can you believe that we're saying 2013? That just sounds nuts, doesn't it?
It's crazy, isn't it? Where does time go?
I don't know.
We're like old. And
look at us
old
people sitting on TV here. Look at that camera thing in front of us.
What is that?
What is that thing?
I don't even know.
I'm on tour. I'm on tour next year. January, February across the UK. Mm-hmm. Start kickoff Jan 16th and... Then I'm going to Europe, then I'm going to Australia. So I'm on the road for a while next year. Can't wait.
And what can your fans expect from this new tour?
All new material. It's all the Fires album and some new Fires. There'll be all the other stuff as well. Yeah. Rollercoaster, Loving Each Day, When You Say Nothing At All. They'll all be thrown in
there. So the big hits that people want to hear.
Oh, I hope they want to hear. They'll be
they
in there.
They will want to hear them.
They'll be in there as well. But definitely all the new material from the album.
Cool.
And a few other bits and pieces. And Brian McFadden's actually coming on the road with me.
He's supporting
me. Yeah, which I'm excited about. It's been a while since Brian has been up this part of the world, working-wise, touring. So he's coming up. He's he's supporting me on the tour here and in Australia. So yeah, I'm excited for him. He's got a new album out as well.
Oh, that's
what
really
am I doing
exciting.
For Brian McFadden for? I mean, for me. What's this about?
Because yeah. you're a nice guy,
no,
Ronan.
No, that's a vicious rumour.
Yeah. So how long does it actually take to prepare for a tour? Is it quite a long process?
I'll do 2 weeks with my band before the first show.
Wow.
Yeah, every day. Singing for, yeah, pretty much just getting it right. It's not like the boys on tours where, you know, we've got dance rehearsals and production rehearsals and all of that. It's a bit more, you know, organic, my solo stuff. So it's literally me out front with the tracks and then the band behind me. So it's a little easier to prepare for that, really, than a boys on tour.
What about the staging of it?
It's, you know, I don't go too elaborate. It's a city hall tour. It's not an arena tour, the solo one. So I'm going into smaller venues. So you can't really put a whole load in there.
Mm.
But I like them. I like that intimacy in a city hall tour, being that close to people. I like
Definitely.
It. Yeah, it's a lot more fun. I really enjoy that.
Cool.
Yeah.
So let's talk about your time in Boyzone.
Mm-hmm.
You are the biggest bands of the 90s, and I was a big fan. I'm not going to lie.
Not anymore, but you were back then.
I will. You got some tunes. I went to the last tour. It was really cool.
Thanks.
Looking back at your time in the band and the experiences you guys went on, how would you sum it up?
It was brilliant. I mean, the first 6 years went very fast. The 90s were a blur, to be honest.
Yeah.
We had a great time, but it went by too fast. We didn't get to enjoy it like we should have. I was hanging out with, as you do, with One Direction recently, doing an X Factor thing together, and those boys just seemed to be enjoying themselves.
Yeah.
And I kind of, I admire them for that they can see it for what it is and they're really having a good time with it. That's really important. I think we took it a little too seriously.
Right.
Then we got back together back in 2007. It was just amazing. We had the best time. That was the best years in the band. Sadly, losing Theo was devastating and, you know, we kind of lost our way. But we're back next year with 20 years of Boyzone, which is frightening. Frightening.
But exciting at the same
time.
Yeah,
it really is exciting. I think we're going to have a whale of a time.
Doing something big for it. Have you got a plan to do like a tour?
Yeah, we're on a tour, definitely.
Yeah.
Oh, we're on a tour and we may have some sort of a record out. We don't know what it is yet.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
cool,
right?
That would be really good.
Be great.
And maybe put out a DVD.
How should we do it all?
Yeah, why not?
Give it a go.
Do the whole thing.
Absolutely.
Big tour, live DVD.
Everything.
New single.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be good.
All of us.
Why not?
Who knows what's
going to
happen?
Put some more grey hairs on your beard.
Some more. Thank you very much. You've noticed, haven't you? Have you noticed?
But I think grey hairs are very handsome, so it's fine, you know.
Yeah, thanks.
So talking of One Direction, did you give them any words of wisdom? Did they ask you for anything?
No, they didn't. No? Not at all. The boys came along as guest mentors with me on my X Factor duties here in London for Australia, and it was great. It was an insight. It was interesting to see how they work together, and you know, they're very talented lads, and they enjoy themselves. They have a great time.
Would you give them any advice?
Keep doing what they're doing, and you know, enjoying themselves is key. I think, you know, don't let it go by. It went by in a blur for us, which is kind of sad.
So just, like, take every moment
ride
as it comes.
Exactly.
Ride the wave.
Yeah.
Now, do you think boy bands nowadays have got it easy compared to how you guys had it back in the day?
I think it's still as hard. I think you still have to work as hard and travel as much. And now I think it's, you know, it was tough for us because we were the first Irish boy band, which was, you know, we made it up as we went along. But, you know, I think it's tough out there still for any band, whether it's a boy band, girl band, solo artist. It's tough. Tough generally.
Yeah, definitely. You've got to work hard as play hard, haven't you?
You do. You've got to work really hard.
Yeah, definitely.
It's good though.
So you were mentioning the Boyzone tours.
Yeah.
So in 2011, you guys went on tour, and the whole tour was based around sort of just giving back to Stephen Gately.
Yeah.
Just, you know, having a good time, enjoying the good times, remembering him, which is such a nice thing to do. So how did you guys feel at the time?
It was very emotional for us, to be honest with you. I don't think any of us enjoyed that tour, if we're really honest, because it was hard.
Mm.
You know, every single night you felt mentally drained when you came off stage. It was very difficult to deal with him not being there. If I'm being honest, I didn't really enjoy that tour. But I'm hoping that this next tour next year will feel different. You know, we'll have a more positive outlook on the tour and what we're doing. So let's see.
Yeah, definitely. 20 years, big 2-0.
Yeah.
Big deal. Now, you've had a hugely successful music career and you've turned your skills into judging others on The X Factor in Australia. So how did that all come about?
Simon asked me to do it. He was putting a show together for Australia, Simon Cowell, and said, you know, would I join the panel? This was 3 years ago. So yeah, I decided to do it. I had, you know, I enjoyed going down to Australia, liked it there, and it just worked for me. It made sense at the time. So yeah, I really enjoyed the last 3 years on the show. It's a lot of fun working on it, you know. You're kind of a one-man record company sitting there on the panel, you know, with your three acts at the beginning and picking songs and outfits, haircuts, I mean, everything yeah. you could think of.
So you're really involved.
Yeah, very much so. You've only one day off a week. I mean, it's a 6 day, you know, it's a 6 day thing. You know.
Jesus, lucky that you're enjoying it.
I really enjoyed it. I do. It's over very fast. It goes by in a blink.
Yeah. Mm. Have you had a chance to look at our version this year?
I haven't seen too much of it. I did have a charity ball recently, and Rylan came along and performed with me, which was a lot of fun. He's a ticket. He was good. Yeah, he was a real ticket. That fella. It was good fun.
Now Louis Walsh still mentions Boyzone on the X Factor. He's very proud of your success. Yeah. Do you guys still keep in touch, have a catch up?
Louis and I have been on and off over the years. I have a lot of respect for Louis. He's done really great, yeah, with Boyzone at the beginning, which started it all off for him as much as us, into Westlife, which was phenomenal. It was huge. He's on the biggest show in the country right now, and he's doing a great job. Louis is great. He's fantastic.
Yeah, he's working hard, isn't he?
He works really hard. Yeah. I know how hard it is to work, sit on that panel and do that. So, yeah, he does.
Definitely. Now, if you were to ask to do some stuff in the UK version of The X Factor, would you leave Australia for us?
I would love to be on the show here.
Really?
I mean, yeah, but my kids are in Dublin, so to be this close, Australia's so far. I love being there, and I'll continue to do that. But, you know, of course, if something came up in the UK, if I could do both, amazing. Wow.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Now, you've gained success in the music industry and in the TV industry. What else would you like to conquer?
Conquer? I don't think I've conquered anything, really. But,
I would
like to do is, I've got my first feature film coming out in March, cool. Which is great. So that's exciting. That's something I want to get into a lot more.
So acting route, maybe?
Yeah, I've been doing quite a bit of that lately. So if I can, the first film's called Goddess, comes out in March. You know, if I can take that on further, I will.
Oh, nice. See Ronan in action in March.
Yeah, not about action, but yeah.
See you doing something.
Something, yes. Yeah.
So we've got quite a few Twitter questions to ask you right now. At Bliss TV followers, have tweeted in loads.
Right.
So I've had to quickly narrow down as many as I can.
Okay.
So let's get through them. Now, Steph would like to know, have you ever dressed up as Santa for your kids?
Yes. Yes, I have. My good friend, Barry Knight, he's 6 foot tall, and it was me, and he got a reindeer outfit that was way too small for him, which was hilarious. I'm sure I have photos somewhere. And then I got one of those, those Santa outfits that you have a little machine and it blows up inside, and it was huge. Well, the sight of the two of us, it was absolutely hilarious.
Did they know it was you?
They knew it was Barry in the reindeer outfit, but they didn't know it was me.
Oh,
it was
wow.
So funny. They were quite young at the time, but we had a real laugh at that. That was funny.
Oh,
really funny.
Well, there we go.
There you go.
He has dressed as Santa.
Steph, there you are.
There we go. Kim would like to know, have you any plans to leave the UK for Australia?
No, I mean, I go down there for X Factor. Whether I do it again this year, I don't know. Do it again next year, I don't know. But I won't leave full time. Not with the kids in Ireland, no way.
Definitely
no,
not.
No way.
Nidhai would like to know, do you prefer sunshine or snow? I'm guessing that's because Australia's quite a hot place.
Yeah, I enjoy both, of course, like we all do. I do like the snow. I was in Australia at the start of when Christmas, the decorations started to go up and the weather was getting very hot. That didn't make sense to me. I needed, you don't feel the atmosphere with a hot Christmas. So coming back into London, landing in Heathrow, and you walk outside and all those trees were lit, it was just magic. It was beautiful. So I'd rather be definitely in colder climates for Christmas, but summer in Australia is amazing.
Can't beat that.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. Joy would like to know, out of all of your songs, which one do you like the best?
I think it changes all the time when you're performing. I like the new single, Wasted Light. It's nice to perform it. Enjoying that. But there are songs in there, The Last Thing on My Mind with Leanne Rimes, which is always a great tune. Life is a Roller Coaster is that song that gets everyone going.
Yeah.
I always have it towards the end of my set and it builds people up and it's a good vibe.
Gets them all excited. And Jack would like to know, if you could be a superhero, who would you be and why?
Oh, I'm Batman. I've always been Batman. Since I was a big, a small, kid, I just loved Batman. It was my favourite.
Aww.
I just love, he was just cool. And it was a bit more believable. Slightly.
Yeah.
Ever so slightly believable. Because he was just human, He didn't actually have a superpower.
Exactly.
So I kind of believed that a lot more as a kid.
Oh, well, there we go, Jack.
There you are,
Jack. Imagine Ronan in a Batman outfit.
There you are. There's an outfit.
There we go. Well, thank you so much for sending all of your tweets. And Ronan, thank you for answering them
for us today. Thank you very much. Thanks for sending the tweets in.
And we come to the end of our chat, I'm afraid. I know, it's quite sad.
It is.
I've had a good time catching up with you today.
You too. Great
Ronan,
to see you.
We wish you the best of luck with the tour.
Thank you.
The latest album and the singles. We're going to sign out with another one of your videos. It's a classic. We're going to throw it back. And you, of course, get to choose which one we sign out with.
Right.
So would you like When You Say Nothing at All, Life is a Roller Coaster, or Loving Each Day?
Oh, wow. What would you like?
Oh, I quite like Loving Each Day.
Let's do it.
Yeah?
This was a lot of fun, actually. We shot this video out in the desert in Australia. In America.
He's got Australia on the mind.
I know, it's on the mind, on the brain. Yeah, we about 2 hours outside of Los Angeles, we found this little kind of diner and a shack, and we shot this video. It was a lot of fun many, many years ago. My God. Here it is, Loving Each Day.
Here we go. Thank you.
Enjoy. Thank you. Thanks.